Hey, welcome. Ah, it's all going on tonight. Welcome in, everyone. How's it been? Wow, 3 days since I've been here. I've had a nice long weekend break. We're back with Dark Unicorns versus Golden X Noble Nine. UWL. Got another one straight after this as well. So busy. Let's go. Hope this is going to be a good one. I have no idea what has happened to the music. What's happened to the music, guys? I've gone into my usual NCS on Spotify and it appears to be all Christmas tunes. Mrs. GG in the house as always. Thank you, Mrs. GG. How's it going? Right, I've got to connect over to Wolf as well. We'll do a voice for this one. He's over in Noble Nines. We'll get a little bit of hype from his side, see what he thinks is going to happen. We'll get the predictions going. We've got predictions working now as well. It's beginning to look a lot like Christmas, apparently. Sounds a bit like me singing in the shower. Ronnie, Golden X, hey, should be a good war. Thanks for covering. Awesome stuff. Ronnie. Are you in the lineup, Ronnie? Yes, it should be a good war. Just a Golden X fan, Ronnie, or part of the actual team. Awesome, looking forward to this one though. It should be an absolutely awesome war. Let's get those predictions going. Then I'm going to hop over to Wolf in voice and then we'll see what he thinks that side of the field. He's in your clan, I believe. So let me start a prediction, guys. Bear with us. First one I've ever done of these. I think we'll just say who will win. So is it going to be Dark Unicorns? Give me a key. Dark Unicorns, or will it be Golden X? Noble Nine, there we go. Start that off for 10 minutes, we'll kick it off, give plenty of people time to start a prediction. Spend your channel points, get in there and gamble. Come on, Mrs. GG, you've got loads of those going there. So this is UWL, guys. Usual spec, one attack each. And we'll run through the lineups, and I'll quickly run through the lineups, and I'll collect a wolf. So on Dark Unicorn's side, we have Gabrielle number one. Got Eve Immel is number two, and I'm not sure on this one. Is it Ixilis is number three? Wasman is number four, and Alpha Unicorn number five. You all know the names. You all know the names this side as well. Noble Nines, base is getting tagged in front of my eyes. We've got Boss in at number one. We've got Stiffy Bobat number two. Virus is number three. Asuka is number four. And Jono is number five. That's Noble Nines' side. Best of luck with both sides. Right, let's quickly connect to Wolf and see what he thinks the other side.
You know, I've had a history in technology and stuff, and I work in technology, I work in digital and everything like that. But when it comes to these things, right, I'm completely confused. You know, it says do exclamation mark.
I'm always confused.
Oh, there we go, GG crew.
He's only here. I made it. I've put my usual music on, and it's come up with all Christmas songs, bizarrely. I don't know what's going on there.
Ah, yes. So tomorrow, I'm adding all my, you've seen my overlays looking quite Christmassy already. But I'm adding all the tracks tomorrow. Okay. All the Christmas tracks, but they're not Christmas tracks as in the ones that you normally hear. Okay. So these are original singers. Okay. So that's going to be quite interesting. Okay, I've listened to a few of them. I actually ordered them about 2 months ago. I thought to myself, and then they only arrived a few days ago. So,
one thing I've got to say is don't forget your prediction if you haven't already. I'm gutted. I'm so used to doing polls, I can't vote in it myself, can I? I've just realised.
I know. So.
Power Mama has just set my alarm bells ringing. Power Mama's over here, Wolf. Our mama coming in with that.
What did she do?
She has just subscribed. She's just sent my heart racing with that alarm going on.
Oh, Power Mama's full of love. Absolutely OP there. OP, yeah, there OP, you go.
So, what do you think? I actually saw your intro on YouTube while I was waiting for my stream to go live. So, yeah, what do you think? What do you think this one's going to be? It's going to be a hell of a match, isn't it?
It's going to be a close match. Sorry to say this, right? Because a lot of people would be thinking it's going to be Dark Unicorns are going to be the favorites here. But no, Noble X, okay? They've got a few, a good players. You got Virus in there. You got Asuka in there. You got Siffy in there. And Boss as well. Gosh, you know, these aren't just like, you know, just the run-of-the-mill players.
Big players, both sides.
Big players, absolutely.
Massive. This is going to be a close war. I tell you, I'm normally do a score prediction as well. I haven't done that, so okay. Have you done score prediction yet?
Well, I did that prediction, the usual prediction, the new points prediction so far. So Winds of Winter has coming in, and he's basically saying 14-15. So I'm presuming he's saying 15 to Dark Unicorns. Whoa, 14-15.
Okay. 15. Okay.
Yeah. Okay.
Okay, that's going to probably change mine.
Okay, so I'm thinking. Okay, wait for it. Right, I'm thinking it's going to be 14 all. Okay, and I think I'm saying Noble's gonna get it 14 all.
Okay, okay. I was gonna go 14 all, so I'll go the other side then.
Dark Unicorns,
we'll cover it from both sides. So I'll go 14 all Dark Unicorns.
Okay, okay.
All right. Yeah. And what else was I going to say? Oh, yeah, attack coverage. So are you going to cover the last attack for?
I'll cover the last attack from Noble.
I'll cover the last attack from Dark Unicorns.
If
I get a few seconds afterwards, I will try and catch up with you after the match as well. But I have got to hop straight over into another war.
Sure. Understandable.
I might or I might not be able to catch up with you afterwards. How is the hype over there then? You've got all the Golden X fans over there, have you?
I don't think there's many people here. Let me just have a quick look. And they're going to be pretty quiet. Oh no, there is quite a lot of people here. Okay, they're all lurking here. Okay, hello to everybody who joined us. So that was a quick little
just gambling those channel points off.
Exactly. Yeah, and then on YouTube, I've got a fair few people there as well. Also, everybody just holding fire. They don't want to say anything, okay? But it's all good, at this moment in time. So we're about 8 minutes away from the attack, first attack coming in.
Then 4 minute windows in for UWL, is that right? Have I forgotten? That's about right, I think. 4 minute windows for blind attack.
Yeah. So what do you think at this moment in time? Offense, okay? We have been seeing absolutely storming attacks at the moment.
I think it just took a week, maybe just over a week post-update. Now people are starting to get really used to the new metas, and you're getting those perfect wars creeping up more and more now.
More and more. Yeah. 14 stars and 15 stars.
Yeah, there's a few of them creeping in there. So hopefully this one is going to bring as much the same. I'm not sure.
Yeah. So let me tell you about a challenge that I've got for when I do my when I'm watching the attacks. Okay, so a lot of people are using this super wizard blimp bomb. Okay, using the invisible spells and the and a rage. So my target percentage, okay, because I've done that already, it might have been a bit of a newbie type attack, but it was 20% of the base. Okay, so that is the target, and I'm always seeing if anybody's beaten is about to beat that 20%. So it was close the other day with 17%. Okay, so we'll see if anybody...
That's the challenge, is it, to beat your 20%? So do you want to see my replay of my 25% one then?
Oh, no!
I'm joking. I can't do the blimp bomb. Let's skip away from it. I've got another couple of metas I've got on the go at the moment. I need to show these guys. Okay. Perhaps I can get in the team. You never know.
Yeah. So,
Okay. All right. Well, you enjoy the match. Hopefully, I'll get a couple of seconds to catch up with you afterwards. If not, just enjoy it and I'll catch you later.
Okay, and Mrs. Gigi Groo is over here as well.
Power Mama's here, Mrs. Gigi's. I think they've swapped roles. I think Power Mama's over here modding for me. Mr. GG, you can. She's modding for you tonight, so
yeah, absolutely. OP.
All right, then. You enjoy it, and I'll catch up with you later. Take it easy, buddy.
Take care. Bye bye.
Bye. Okay, guys, that was Wolf on the other side, on the dark side. I'm on the dark side. I'm on Dark Unicorn's side here. This is Dark Unicorns versus Golden X Noble Knights. And like I say, guys, hope you like Christmas. I stepped into NCS releases on Spotify and I've got Christmas songs. Don't know why. Stick with it for now. It's nearly Christmas. What is it? 1, 2, 3, 4 more sleeps. And we'll be Monday night, Tuesday night, Wednesday night, Thursday night. Yeah, 4 more sleeps. 4 more sleeps. It's been a long week already and it's only Monday. Right. So, as Wolf said, we've got about 5 minutes before this one kicks off. I see the gambling has already gone in favour of Golden X. Golden X. Leading the prediction there. Hello, Mama. Are you still in the house? Or back with what I want to know, actually, Power Mama, is when you're over in this chat, how come I don't get the chili chips? That's what I need. Coming in with that subscription saying hello, hello, hello. Thank you for that, Power Mama. Appreciate it. I'm Ronnie Golden X. Sorry, I was just starting the stream, just catching up. Thank you for that, followers. Appreciate it. Good luck to both sides. To work out who's voted on the thing. I need to work out how to work this. Work it out afterwards. Get to. So, since I changed to Mrs. Wolfgang J, I don't. You did prove tired, to be honest. Painkillers. My mum's still suffering a little bit there. Hopefully, you'll get well soon. Hear them all day on the radio. So I'm not going to watch them during the stream as well. We'll save that for Christmas Eve. So we've got about 3 minutes before this one kicks off, guys. UWL. Group stages still. And then we'll be stepping out of this one straight into Global Clash Card quarterfinal. Penta coming up. Penta versus Valerie Mugger. That'll be an awesome match too. So two absolute corkers coming up for you tonight. And I've got another one coming up tomorrow night. Booked one for tomorrow night now. What have we got tomorrow night? Crew 99 versus Evolute TFCC in the Class Masters League tomorrow night. That's at 8 o'clock UTC. Guys, check out the Twitter as well of us. Check out my Twitter. Got a giveaway going on Twitter at the moment. If you fancy a shot at the giveaway, it's just the usual retweet, tag two people. Draw for that is going to be on the 27th, which is my birthday. So let's go do a birthday stream on the 27th, hopefully. Right, 1 more minute to go, so let's run through the lineups here. All 5 bases tagged from Dark Unicorns. They know what they're doing there. So we've got Boss in at number 1. This is on Noble Signs. Iffy Bobat is number 2. Virus is number 3. Asgar is number 4. And Lee late Jono, number 5. That is Golden X, Noble Knight. Then on Dark Unicorn side, we've got Gabrielle, number 1. Eve Timo is number 2. Ixilis is number 3. Wazman is number 4. And Alpha Unicorn, number 5. Let's go. So if you don't know me, guys, if you get a 3-star, you get a boon. Hello, boon. If it's a really good 3-star, you'll get a hell yeah on top of that. Get a 3-star. Right? Hopefully, we'll see lots of that tonight. I've got a feeling tonight this is going to be an absolute screamer. For those of you predicted in chat, God knows how I pay it out at the end. I have no idea. We'll worry about that when we get to it. We've got a live. Let's go. Eve Timo is in. Good luck. Coming in with a hybrid. And that blimp bomb stepping in over those loons. Coming in towards that scatter shot. Down goes. No rage. They're doing it on their own. The Yeti's coming out of there. World Champ is hammering them, the Scattershot is hammering them. Didn't get a huge value there. Got the CC pull, got the Expo, but no rage used. Queen steps in, the Kogaloon over the top of the Queen at 230. Got the Poison down over the Super Minions. Super Minions escape the Poison, but the Queen should deal with them comfortably now. Two down, third one falls to the Poison. The Yeti is in at 4 o'clock, and the Queen can push into that 3 o'clock corner. Still no spells used here. We're holding on to those spells as long as we can. Queen just coming around that 3 o'clock corner in towards this air defense, and she's going to check in there. In comes the super wall break. Going to open up that compartment in front of that scatter shot. There goes the first rage spell. We've got this multi inferno locked onto the Queen. He took care of the Royal Champ as well. Now walking the crawl up to that 12 o'clock side. In comes another super wall breaker. It's going to fall into that blank compartment, unfortunately, but it will give the Queen access for that scatter shot. It's giving her a bit of grief at the moment. The single inferno locked on at the minute. She's got the enemy King stepping in as well. Puts the freeze down, catches the King. The inferno tower already dealt with, but the King goes down as well. Good stuff from the Queen. World Champ stepping in at 2 o'clock, walking up to 12 o'clock. Queen's still working really hard. She's tanked by that Expo, trying to recover, but the healers are down now. The scattershot finishing the healers off. The Queen walks into the tornado trap. She's in a world of pain now and about to go down on the outside. So the hybrid stepping straight in towards the town hall. Yo, 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 Felon is in the house. Welcome in, Felon. Are you getting excited? It's nearly Christmas, buddy. Town hall goes down. The rage spell is down there. The warden tone goes off. Heal spell beyond the town hall. Queen is waiting for those troops that appear in that side. It's the multi inferno. We've lost all the hybrid in the core. Headhunter coming in, but taken out quite quickly by the Queen. Miners lock onto the multi inferno. The multi inferno goes down, but the Queen is picking them off as fast as she can. Two scatter shots raining in on those miners is going to finish them off really quickly. So it looks like we're almost done here with this first hybrid coming in from Eve Timo. Is it going to finish? Ooh, we do get into the 70s. Two wizards and an archer still going to work up at 12 o'clock. Going to get a couple of extra percent. A nice try, Eve Timo. It's not the triple he was looking for, I'm sure. 72%, good try. Two star opener. Okay. That is Dark Unicorns opening us up. Noble Nines coming in next. Gold Neck Noble Nines. How's it going, Felon? Anyway, long time no chat. I got nothing to be scared of. Because where people live, there is always love. I know the answers in my heart. So I'll try my best. It's waiting for this next live to come in. I think it's 4 minute windows on UWL, so I think we're looking at 36 minutes for Gold Next to come in. Gonna be Boss, Siffy Bobat, Virus, Asuka, or it is Boss coming in number one. Good luck again. What we got this time? Ooh, we've got you would say a Yeti smash. We've got five hogs in there as well. Okay, so we're starting off as usual with the Yetis, with the Warden Walk coming in at 9 o'clock. Just clearing this 9 o'clock side. Balloon over the top, no healers attached yet. Warden now has got the healers as he steps in towards that Archer Tower and that scatter shot. Taking that gold storage down, now moving in towards that Archer Tower. He's got both Archer Towers tanking him at the moment. Out of range of that scatter shot, two Yetis coming in, and the rest all coming in at the top here. Straight away, we've got the siege barracks deployed on the outside at 12 o'clock. In through that super wall break, then into that rage spell with the queen as well. Jump spell waiting beyond that rage. The eagle goes down. And we're just waiting for these bowlers, Yetis. The king is in there as well with the queen. Gets onto this single inferno. The warden tone goes off. The tornado trap fires in behind that single inferno. The hogs come in from the siege barracks with the royal champ. Perhaps that's what those extra five hogs were used to back up the hogs coming in from the siege barracks. So the queen's going to check the jump spell. She locks onto the town hall. Royal champ is on the outside. The town hall goes down. And the queen can get through this gap into this expo compartment here, but she's going to do the sensible thing and take the jump spell. There goes the champ's ability, the single inferno locked on. We've got nothing to stop that single inferno taking the royal champ down. And the queen falls down in that bottom compartment, so we're not going to get a triple with this one as well. But it's a nice try, Boss. Golden X, Noble Nines coming in with a two star. Not the Lalo God felon. Felon with the Lalo God emote saying, looking pretty good, pretty good. Felon, do you actually play Clash of Clans? Need to teach you what a Lalo attack is. Apologies if you do play it. I'm not sure if you play it or not. I know you're a big Among Us player. Almost up into 80% here. We've got plenty of time for the archer to work on that gold mine, or the cannon will rip that archer to pieces. So we're going to get to 80%. That will see Boss and Noble Nines, Golden X, step out in front here after the first attack. Two apiece, they should lead on destruction. Oh, Felon is into the streaming. Wow, good stuff, Felon. There we go, two apiece, one attack each. That early lead for Golden X. All I can say to that then, Felon, is that watch out because Felon is fast. You know it. There we go then, 32 minutes of time of the next attack coming in. There will be Dark Unicorns to come in next. So Golden X, Noble Nines with that early lead. We've all gone for very high score predictions here. I think almost 14 was the lowest in the score prediction. Oh, we might even see a perfect from one side. Now that's not going to be the case now. Then we've got a Lalo in here now. This is where you can use that Lalo God then, Felon. In comes two loons in front of that air defense, and the blimp following straight in behind. We've got one spell of invisibility here. And that's the clone spell dropped. Out comes the E-Drag, the blimp bomb clearing that compartment, almost getting the enemy queen down. Do we finish off the queen? Oh, we don't quite. Oh, yes. Does he get the queen? In fact, that E-Drag death damage does finish off the queen there. The baby drag is being tackled by the headhunter, but the baby drag can finish that off comfortably. In comes a nice golem at 8 o'clock. Queen steps in behind. The good stuff from the blimp bomb then. We do tackle the enemy queen. King steps in at 9 o'clock, walking around the top, and the royal champ is in between the two royals. The ice golem has done, so the royal champ's going to step in towards the royal champ and that single inferno. There's a spell of invisibility. The queen will get the single inferno down. Good stuff. And the royal champ is tackling the enemy RC with the help of the king. The king is moving back in for the scatter shot. Queen can't reach the eagle, but the royal champ tackles that instead. Velen comes in with the Lalo God. Let's hope we can use them. I don't normally use them unless it's a free star. The king is done. And the royal champ is about to be done. Queen's still got a fair bit of health as we start this Lalo in then, around that 12 o'clock corner. All the way down to 1:30, and the last hand coming in at 2:30. And those loons dropping all the way around that top side then. Queen's ability is fired. She's going to come through an opening in the wall, is she? No. Yes, she does. In come these loons then towards the town hall. There goes the warden tone and capture the queen in there as well. The town hall goes down, pushing in towards this multi-inferno now. We've got the sweeper giving these loons grief. The haste spell and a freeze going down over that multi. Multi-inferno goes down. The queen is still up here. She's tackling the enemy king. And she survived the enemy king. I don't think so. The king's going to win that battle. So we've got these expo. We've got the single inferno to worry about. We've still got one lava hound up. This is looking pretty solid. The haste over the top of that single inferno. And in come the last pack of loons. This is a nice triple from Ixalis. And as Felon says, with those Lala God emotes, it is going to be a three star. So that's a boom. Nice one. I think we did drop the air horn in there by mistake as well. Get that one. A three stars. Let's go. And as you say, Felon, that is worth the Lalo God emote. Nice stuff there from Ixalis. Dark Unicorns taking that five-star lead. Good stuff. Only the elite few. You could really do with an early night, but with that blocked nose, a good night's sleep is Ixalis has earned that Lalo God emote. Good stuff. Here we go then. Asuka is coming in on Wasmon. Got one zap. We've got two quakes. Are we looking to get a scatter shot, single shot here? Tap now to learn more about the Otrivin range. Otrivin adult meter dose 0.1% nasal. Got 11 drags. Azoline hydrochloride for congestion relief. Always read the label. No, we're going for the single inferno at the top. We've got one quake spell left. In comes that single shot. Single inferno still up here. We haven't. And the zap is used to reset. We did activate the town hall with that quake, and that town hall does zap the royal champion down. We've got sneaky goblins coming in at the side between 8 and 9 o'clock. Two loons and the baby drag over the top of that archer tower at 10. And in come the dragons then, split right between 9 and 10 o'clock. Loons either side, and the warden stepping in behind. And a straight path in towards the queen and this multi-inferno. There goes the rage spell. Blimp sent over the top and that warden tome fired. And that will see that blimp all the way to the town hall. Put the quake down over the scatter shot and that expo. And the king and queen coming in at 7 o'clock. The town hall goes down. We put the freeze over the scatter shot and the sweeper there. And the dragons take care of the sweeper. The second freeze going down over that scatter shot, looking to get the eagle down here as well into that rage spell. Eagle still up, but it goes down. Scatter shot starting to rain in on these dragons now. We find the tornado trap at 6 o'clock. That third freeze spell used for that bottom side scatter shot still stood up here. and it does eventually fall to those two dragons that are going to come down to that multi-inferno in that 3 o'clock compartment. Right, this pack of dragons, we've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 of them pushing up into the 3 o'clock compartment with the queen. Queen on the outside, ability fired. Gonna get that air defense down. Multi inferno falls, but three dragons left now. Two are really low on health. A queen taking care of the mortar. We're gonna get to the queen's a little bit slow getting to the expo and the whiz tower. That's gonna do the damage. Two dragons still up, but the queen does go down. The expo goes down. We've got one dragon left with the warden, who's 3/4 health. Can we get it done? We've got 35 seconds left. We've got 7% to get through. The archer tower is tackling that dragon now. I think we can do this, you know. I think we've got time. Dragon, warden, archer tower, done. One more cannon left. Not going to affect the air defense. We're at 15 seconds left, 2% to get. This is going to be a triple from Golden X. And Asuka coming in with a triple, leveling this up again. Nice stuff. Boom. Keep these booms going, guys. Good stuff from Asuka. Leveling it up at 5 apiece. That's where we're at. 36% Golden X Noble Nines. 34.4 for Dark Unicorns. What we've had so far. Bit of cagey 2-star opener from both sides. And stepping straight into those triples now. Good stuff. Good stuff, good stuff. Oh my god, I forgot it's 4-minute windows. I was just checking the chat up there. And I just realized the next one should be coming in any second. Three left to come, both sides. 5 apiece. Into the triple zone now. Keep it going, guys. As Ronnie said from Golden X earlier, it should be a hell of a map. Here we go. Dark Unicorn, send this Alpha Unicorn in from number one. Again, we got a Lalo coming in. We've got 2 spells of invisibility in this one. Are we going to see that Limp Bomb coming in with those invisibility spells? Not sure. In at the top, the dragon's in with the super wall break. Dragon? Giant. That's a giant. That's not a dragon. Ice Golem. King and Queen behind the Ice Golem. Super wall break there. Must have been a double one. We caught that first compartment and then into the main compartment for the Eagle. Royal Champ steps in at 2. Into that scattershot. Ability fired early. And she's going to take care of that scattershot. The King finds the tornado trap. And he's tackling the enemy king, the enemy queen, and trying to get the eagle down all at once. The queen's under a bit of pressure here. And her ability will be forced. Got enemy king, eagle, expo, enemy queen waiting there as well. Can she finish off the queen here? This would be really good if she can. I don't think she will. No, she does go down to the enemy queen. So we've still got enemy queen. We've still got royal champ in here for these loons. And we've still got a long way to go to that town hall. We have still got the blimp. We've still got the spells of invisibility. In comes the warden behind that first pack of loons. In comes the blimp over the top of the warden. Straight in towards the queen there. No, the blimp's not going to make it here. The rage spell goes down. Perhaps the blimp didn't want to make it. Into that multi-inferno channel was the source for those super wizards coming in there. There goes the warden tone. Super Wizards, can they finish off the enemy queen? Yes, they do get the enemy queen. Got a freeze over the town hall. The royal champ's still up here. Haste spell for that town hall. And the haste managing to save some of those loons. Moving up towards that single inferno and that whiz tower. A royal champ is going to pick off those loons though as they try and get that inferno tower down. And it is not going to be a triple this time. That nasty looking Tesla farm up there at 4 o'clock as well was going to stop these loons in a hurry. That's a 2-star, it's a nice try. Warden's still got plenty of life left in him, but he's so close to that Royal Champ. He's going to take care of that Expo. Then we get into the 80s. Seconds left. Air defense trying to finish off the last minions and doing so. Warden tackling the enemy RC here. Not going to get much more value. He is going to get the RC done. Stepping in towards that gold elixir storage. He's going to get that too. So we get to 83% before he goes to the single inferno. Nice try, Alpha Unicorn. 2 stars. Takes us to 7. 7-5, but Golden X still with 1 to come. 3-2, that's where we're at. What we've had. Both 2-star in on their first, both triple in on their second, and Alpha Unicorn coming in for his third. And Jono coming in straight away then. With Super Witches. 4 Super Witches, 4 Super Wiz in this one. 1 spell of invisibility. Warden in at 9 o'clock. How far can we go with these Super Witches? No zaps. We've got 2 jump spells and a single rage in this one. 2 rage, sorry. Count that 3. Check again. Warden working hard on that 9 o'clock corner. 1 King and the Super Witch in there at 10 o'clock, 10:30. Looking to pull the Warden. The rest of the Witches coming in. With the Queen between 9 and 10 o'clock. Jump spell already placed there for them. Limp coming in towards the Town Hall. Just catching that Warden time as well. Raid spell there, but the Witches are going south. And they've all walked around the outside here, bar one. And one's going to take the jump spell with the Queen, we think. So not a great split on these Witches. Super Witches, Super Wizards coming in to support the Witches on the outside. The second jump spell coming in for the Eagle. Queen takes care of the top side and moving in towards that scattershot. The blimp gets the Town Hall done with the Yetis. Queen moves into the scattershot. He's got 2 healers, 3 healers on the Super Witches. Actually locked onto the Super Wiz at the moment. And now back onto the Warden. So Queen's ability is 4. She takes care of that Expo. Comes in for that jump spell again and jumps the right side. Gonna get the Multi Inferno in the core. But we've lost most of the Super Witches here. We've still got the Royal Champ to come. We've still got a spell of invisibility. It's Queen versus Enemy Queen, and the Enemy Queen is going to win that battle. He's going to tackle those healers. Queen's going to take care of the Warden. She does go down to that Super Witch. Spell of invisibility at that 3 o'clock corner, protecting those loons and the Royal Champ initially. Royal Champ coming in for that defending Warden and then that scatter shot. 1 Super Witch left on the outside. Royal Champ's going to get the scatter shot done. And she is about to succumb to that Multi Inferno in the core. So we've got well into the 80s here. Hard work there. It was a good recovery from that first split here. I think we were looking for everything to come in through that top jump spell. Either way, it was a great recovery. Old Neck, Noble Nine's going to get 85 and more, perhaps, with this last remaining Super Witch. Can she get in through this wall with that big boy? 8 seconds left. Running out of time. I don't think we're going to get much more here. No, we're done on time. It's a good effort. Old Neck's Noble Nine coming in with that. 2 stars, 85%. Thank you for that follow. We've got Penta sneaking in for the next match coming up. Appreciate it. 7 all, guys. Dark Unicorns. Double 9. Pretty close on destruction as well. That's what we're at so far. But in the lead, just our Golden X Noble Knights. And any second now, the next attack coming in for the Dark Unicorns. How's it going? PX, enter. Looking forward to your 10 o'clock war coming up, hopefully. Global Clash Cup quarterfinals following this one, guys. We've got Penta versus Valerie. That's going to be a good one. Well, I'm sure Penta might. Come in. That's what. Oh, that's how you put it. Welcome in, and best of luck for later on as well. I think I applied to your clan a little bit earlier. Check how I'm getting on now. We haven't got in. I'll have to reapply. Here we go then, Gabrielle coming in. Oh no, I'm in. We're in the clan for the next war as well. Super Witch is coming in again. Super Witch Zap this time. We've got six Zaps on Quake. Are we looking for a scatter shot somewhere? There's a scatter shot. Enemy Queen has just jumped out from behind that scatter shot. No, we're going to take the Inferno Tower instead. I'm going to do a little bit of damage to the Queen. Didn't get much on the Queen there. Warden in at 3 o'clock. Loon doesn't quite get to that air defense. Warden gonna take the elixir storage down the Queen and the two Super Witches in. Moving in towards that air defense and the rest of the Super Witches coming in, collecting those healers and moving in towards that first compartment, the other side of the town hall there. The big boys have spawned and going up the outside. We've got the CC pull. Two super minions in there, which is stepping into that first compartment. Enemy Queen has been taken care of. Two super wall breaks coming in and opening up that middle compartment, and again that back end where the town hall is. That's a brilliant super wall break there, giving the Queen access to get right through that channel and pick off everything she wants to. We can keep her up here. The healer's still attached. To get to that air defense, we've got the Royal Champ waiting in that expo compartment. The Witch is through there as well. The jump spell for good measure as that Warden Tome goes off. One Super Witch trying to tackle the Royal Champ. She goes down. The Queen is going to take out the enemy RC as the attacking RC steps in at 9 o'clock. Hogs coming in from the siege barracks. Everything into this 9 o'clock compartment. Single Inferno locks onto the Queen, and that is going to finish off the Queen. Hogs will tackle the single Inferno. Royal Champs on the outside. Single Inferno goes down, moving in towards the Eagle, but the enemy King in there as well is going to stop them getting that Eagle down. The enemy King is now about to tackle the Royal Champ. Royal Champ's ability fired. And Headhunters do get to that enemy King, but he does finish off the Royal Champ in there. She's done. Wizards will get the Eagle. Big boys on the outside, one, two super witches with the healers. Just time here. Still a little bit of base to get through. We've got 22%, and I think we are going to be short of time. Single Inferno eating through those wizards. We finished off the Grand Warden with the single Inferno. Big boys still going strong. Two super witches working around the outside. We're going to get into the 90s. But we're not going to see this one triple. It's a nice try from Gabrielle. One Super Witch about to go down to that single Inferno. The other one escapes the range. Moving up to the top, 94%. Good try. So, we are 9-7. 69.8% to 53%. Level 9s, still got one to come in to level it up. This could go any way. Anyway, it's been neck and neck all the way through. Almost to the stage where a triple could take it now. 12 minutes of time for Noble 9s to come in. Second. Here we go. Virus is coming in for Golden X. Good luck, Virus. Coming in with the dragons, the E-Drag. Got Drag Bat. Five bat spells. In comes the E-Drag on that 9 o'clock corner with the Coca Loon in front. working that 9 o'clock corner clear on the outside. Get a shot, no locks on. You do get the outside trash done on the 9 o'clock corner. The queen and king are in with the giant on that 12 o'clock corner, leaving a path for these dragons to work straight in towards the eagle with the loons and the warden. King's ability is forced by that single inferno. He's going to check into that compartment, but the single inferno is going to put the king down. Locked over the top of the eagle. The eagle goes down. The scattershot goes down. Super minions come out of the CC. And there goes the warden tome. The super minions are done. Single inferno locks onto the queen, forcing the queen's ability. Got a long walk to get round to that single inferno. Can she make it? In fact, she takes the mortar first and is not going to get that inferno tower down. Dragons get the town hall down, and that black seeking air mine has all but finished off the last of the dragons. One more dragon left, just about to fall. Wow, where did these dragons disappear to? But we've still got the bat spells to come, and in fact the warden has done. In comes the royal champ as well. We got the single inferno. It's going to be frozen by that ice golem, but the haste spell and the rage spell there for the royal champ. Single inferno goes down. In comes the bat bomb over the scatter shot. The sweeper causing a little bit of grief, and the scatter shot goes down. Bats can move on into the sweeper. The expo, we've got no more free spells left. There's a split before that whiz tower, but the whiz tower is going to finish off those bats with the royal champ. Minions on the outside then. Going to take us into 70%. Archers down the bottom. Possibly get another couple. Plenty of time left as well. Look at the time left on this one, guys. 70% into 71. The Quattro, the drag expert, saying a little bit of a weird plan with that one. I think they fell short, didn't they? They all stumbled in at the core. I'm not a drag expert on that one. I would leave that one for you, McQuattro. You're the drag expert. Pack drag bats as well. You like drag bats. Welcome in anyway, McQuattro. How's it going? And we've got this one, and we've got Enter coming up right afterwards. Quarterfinals, Global Clash Cup. Okay, 73% virus. It's a nice try and a weird plan, according to McQuattro. But 9 apiece, good stuff. In fact, that does leave us short now. Dark Unicorns with the lead with the destruction with their last 94% effort. That's what we've had. One attack left each. All the predictions. I did triple with scales. There you go, in the Kendro stream. Good stuff. Yeah, I'm all good here, thank you. Been busy, busy, busy. 3 days off of streaming though, but busy in sort of work and whatnot. Wasman is in for the last attack. Dark Unicorns. In comes this blimp on then towards this single inferno. We've got the royal enemy royal champ in there as well. The rage spell goes down. Spell of invisibility goes down. Super wizards get to work. Inferno tower goes down. Royal champ still up here. She's on half health. We're looking to get this scatter shot as well. In fact, the royal champ was covered by that spell of invisibility, so she wasn't going to get done. Maybe drag coming to clear up the trash on the outside on that 3 o'clock corner. We pulled the CC though, we've got Headhunter and Super Minions left in there. In come again, Dragons and Loons working in towards this Town Hall. From 12 o'clock to 2 o'clock is the spread. The King is down the outside. Queen is walking just on the outside, I think. She hasn't stepped in yet. We push in towards that single Inferno. Big split in the dragon. Well, not a split, a big spread in the dragons here. Trying to push on towards this town hall. The king's ability was fired, but he was taken out by the enemy queen. So So it's going to enemy queen versus our queen. Warden Tome goes off, the town hall goes down. The enemy queen will fall here, and the royal champ comes in from 9 o'clock. Right towards that air defense. Got one free spell left here. We've still got both royal champ and the queen's ability as well as we try and clear those tethers in the core. Moving on towards that bottom scattershot and the eagle here. Dingle Inferno locks onto the queen straight away, and she is going to be ability forced. And I think that single Inferno also took out the Royal Champ. Single Inferno again is about to finish off the Queen. So again, we get into the 70s. Xmas can come. He's bought all the liquor, so he's ready. Let's go, let's go. Party time for McQuattro then. It'll be a weird one though, isn't it? It'll be a quiet one. Pretty much we are on our own here. Celebrate it on your own. I think I need to come and see you to get a drag plan. That's what I need. 83% I think we'll scrape here. Possibly more. No, 84. The mid-80s. See, I'd be happy with that personally, but... I know Wasman won't be. Single Inferno was the one that stopped this one. I'm not sure why the Royal Champ didn't get the Single Inferno down. I was watching the pack of dragons in the core. I think with that Single Inferno down, it could have been a different story. It was a nice try. Wasman, Dark Unicorns, finishing them off at 11. So, Noble Nines knowing exactly what they've got to do to triple four. Let's work it out. Gonna be a pretty high two star. I'm looking as if I could work it out exactly. I can't. I know it's got to be a fairly high two star. Anything in the 90s two star, high 90s for a two star or a triple, we'll see them through. It is Siffy Boback coming in for Golden X, Noble Nines, Spell of Invisibility, the blimp to the town hall, the rage spell going down, the super wizard's going to work, but we do spring that tornado trap, which captures, I think the town hall got a shot off on three of those super wizards there, and the last one is taken care of, so we don't get the town hall down. No, we got an artificial one, we got a white one, the Quattro. So no real tree. We have had real trees in the past, but not this year. So we're sticking up with the artificial one. Have you got a real one? I bet you have. Got to. E-Drag going to work on that 6 o'clock corner. It will be plan B. And we have got E-Drags coming in for this one. Baby Drag up at 3. Got 3 Rage. We've still got 1 Spell of Invisibility. In come the loons, in come the E-Drags, in spread from 5 to 4 o'clock, pushing in towards the town hall. We did hope the town hall had already been down. Warden Tome early, one E-Drag locking onto that town hall. In comes the Royal Champ, there's a Spell of Invisibility, nice placement of that spell. We should get the town hall down here. Rage spell for the other E-Drags up at the top. Being tanked by both scattershots though. They're in a world of pain up there. Town Hall does go down. Royal Champ stalled with those skelly spells. He's going to tackle one of the scattershots. The Queen is on the outside with the King tackling the Lava Hound. Now, can we get this next scattershot down while the King is tanking that X-Bow? We do get that scattershot down. We get the X-Bow down as well. The Eagle is on about 1 HP. King's ability fired on the outside. Queen checks in for the Eagle. Again, we're not going to triple. Are we going to get a high enough 2-star here for this one? Yeah, you can't beat the smell from it. It's just the mess. I think the mess. Don't forget we've got the 2 Golden Retrievers as well. They get a bit overexcited at Christmas. And that real Christmas tree... A little bit of a struggle for them. Queen's ability forced. Royal Champ is going to get taken care of. But the Multi-Inferno and the Expo pushing hard to stop the Queen in her tracks, and we do stop the Queen. So we're going to get to, what do we get to here? We can't get to 80%. Is it enough? I don't know. I think that takes us to 11 all, possibly a win here for Dark Unicorns. I've got going. Next match should be starting. Oh my god. Right, there we go. 11 all. GG's both teams. That is Noble Nines, 83.4 to 86.8. And that was that, guys. Dark Unicorns, Noble Nines, GG's both. But I've just realised the time. This one overrunning by a few minutes. I've got to switch out and go straight to the next war. Well played, both. Thanks for letting me in for that one. Oh, look at that. What perfect timing. Perfect timing. Penta versus Valor Morghulis. Or Valerie Morghulis. Morghulis. Coming in. The King. We've got the Queen. We've got the Golem in there. We've got the Super Wall Break. King stepping in for that. Scattershot. Taking care of the Scattershot. I'll get a chance to change the titles in a second. Queen checking in for the Eagle. The Royal Champ coming in at 9 o'clock as well. We are looking at a Lalo here. Can we get the Lalo gone? The moat's going for this. In come three loons trying to get that Scattershot. Take at least a distraction from the Queen. All three Royals trying to get through to the Royal Champ. And the enemy King. The enemy King goes down. The blimp comes over the top. Queen's going to take care of the Royal Champ with her ability. Oh, there's that tornado trap. There's the poison spell for the headhunters. Loons and a dragon coming out. Can we get that multi down in the core? No, the loons fall short. Dragon is trying to take care of it and can't get the job done. More loons with a haste spell coming for that scatter shot. And we start the Lalo at 4 o'clock. This is all go. All the way up to that 3 o'clock corner. The Queen's still going, but she's in a world of pain with that single Inferno. And it does finish her off. More loons coming in the other side. Still trying to get towards this multi-inferno in the core. We've got a freeze over the Town Hall. And the Town Hall with the Warden Tome is about to fall here. We do get rid of that multi-inferno in the core. Clever stuff with that second pack of loons. And those loons pushing up north here. We've got the air defense, the single inferno, and the Tesla farm up there at 11 o'clock looking pretty harrowing, shall we say. There's the haste spell going down towards the defending warden, the air defense. Air defense falls, the single inferno next. But that Tesla farm on the outside is going to do a lot of damage to this last pack of loons. Can we get it done? There is a split. That seeking air mine with those air SAMs coming up now does take care of the rest of those loons. Just the warden left. We've got the clear up minions. It is an awesome recovery. Awesome recovery. Can't quite get the Lalo God for this one if it doesn't triple, and I think it's just too much. The Warden's giving it a good go though. Can he get that Tesla down? Minions are trying. We've got one Tesla left. Oh, that's painful. 96%. Great start. Imagine stepping straight into that one. Right, let me get the titles changed, guys. This is good stuff, good stuff. It is Penta. Versus. I'm going to say Valerie Morghulis. Can't do that special Y on my keyboard. It is Global Clash Cup. I'll get the logos changed. Don't worry. It's been a hot step over to this one. Another lot coming in. It's so hot on times. Wow. There's the titles changed anyway, guys. I'll get to the rest in a minute. Here we go. We've got the Blimp Bomb coming in. Spells of Invisibility. Those Super Wiz going to work there right on the edge of those spells. Did we manage to save them? I think we've still got one or two up, but we did. Still going strong in there. The next spell of invisibility coming down. We've still got that multi-inferno up. Are we going to get that done? One more shot? No, we're just short. And the Super Millions just stopping them getting to that Multi Inferno. The King steps in then. Poison spell goes down over those Super Minions. The King is in at 8 o'clock. Again, we're looking at a Lalo here. Queen steps in for the Super Minions, and the Super Minions are done. Queen takes the Archer Tower down at 9 o'clock. The King's still on the outside. Super Wall Break comes out. Got the Ice Golem and the Yeti stepping in there towards the Town Hall. So this is going to be a good recovery again from that initial Super Whiz Blimp Bomb. King is going to tackle Town Hall. King's ability will be forced here. The Ice Golem freeze should go off perfectly. It doesn't. It's slightly delayed. We do get the Town Hall down though. And the King comes out of that alive. How did he manage to do that? The Queen's ability forced as we moved in. That is an awesome Sui. King coming out alive from that Town Hall is OP. The Queen, we get the Spell of Invisibility there. Lord Champ gets it too. Now the Queen's not going to go too much further. She's just beaten on a wall. She's tanked by that scatter shot. Lord Champ can clear that 12 o'clock compartment, and this Lalo wrapping in from 1 o'clock all the way down to 3 o'clock. The two haste spells. Loon's pushing in with the Warden Tome in towards the Eagle and this scatter shot in that 3 o'clock channel. Scattershot about to fall. The Eagle is the next to fall. We're pushing in towards that bottom compartment. Still got the enemy Queen in there though. The Core still holding that Multi Inferno with the Scattershot, and the Queen is going to rip through those Loons. Single Loon coming in over this mortar. Do get the Multi down though. Queen takes care of the Warden. Pushing in towards this Tesla on the outside. Again, it's going to be a nice try with the Lalo. Louie coming in for Penta with an opening 2-star. Gets us into the 80s. But the enemy Queen still up. Is just going to finish this one off. 10 seconds left. We're into the mid-80s. It's a good try again. You're right. Can I get back to my other title? No. Here we go. Enter. Louie. 2 stars. Openers. 85%. We're at 2 apiece. 19.2. Valerie in the lead against Penta with the 17%. Sorry, guys. I'm getting in to try and change my titles. Been a bit of a manic start and I can't get anywhere I need to go.
Something about it now. This is happening, so make sure you have everything covered. We haven't got long.
Cheers, McQuattro is on the Christmas juice. Cheers, McQuattro. Right, those titles are updated. Let's get rid of that logo. Thank you, UWL, for that pre-war. Sorry, it overran a bit, guys. There we go. This is Global Clash Cup. The titles are all changed. It's been a bit of a manic chase, but we got here. And this is the quarterfinals. There's only 8 left in the Gothic division. This is Penta versus Valerie Moore, guys. And we are sponsored by Creek and Clash and Agam, guys. So as always, a massive shout out to the sponsors for this. See their logos now spinning around by my ugly mug up there at in that corner. That corner, there it is, right there. Agam's logo, Creek and Clash, Global Clash Cup, Gothic division. Like I'm a pro, it's like I've done it before. We've caught up again, guys. Back to the chat. Here we go. Hello, Helpless R6. Welcome in on YouTube. How's it going? We're in here watching Global Clash Cup. Are you supporting anyone in particular? We've got Penta versus Valerie Morgulis. That's exactly how you pronounce it. Here you go. This is the lineup. We didn't get a chance to do the lineup. We had Eve Muffin in there on Penta side. We've got Penta Louis. We've got Penta EPI. We've got Zakia in on number four and GK Tim. That's Penta's side. And then on Valerie's side, we've got Drogon, number one. Rigo Torres, number two. Zeus War, number three. Villa is number four. And Fathom is number five. That's the lineups. And we've got Fathom in now. Both have an awesome lineup. We're expecting this one to go a long way into the double figures. Warden Walk coming in at 2 o'clock. Got Mass Witches coming up. 12 witches in this one. 4 super wall breaks in there as well. With Zapped in the core. Care of the Inferno Tower. And the Warden still, well, he's cleared that middle compartment nicely. We've got an Ice Golem in front of Witches and the Queen at 3 o'clock. And piling the rest of those witches in behind the queen. Loons over the top. I didn't have a chance. This war was behind Power Mama. I'm straight into this war. I was late getting to the next war. So I did tell Wolf that I possibly wouldn't get in at the end. He should know that I probably couldn't make it back. Witches stepping in towards the town hall there. And we pull the CC. We've got two super minions and headhunters coming out. The CC steps into that poison spell. The witches wrap around this town hall. The rage spell there. The warden tone goes off. The town hall still standing but about to fall to that sea of skellies, which gets destroyed by the town hall gigabomb. King working up the outside. And we've got Valks coming in to support the King and the Pekka working up that outside corner, but the King does go down. Valks move on into that top compartment with these witches and Queen pushing in towards this top scatter shot. Super wall break coming in there as well, opening up that compartment. Gives the Queen access more than anything to the single Inferno here. Super wall break goes off at the top as well. Nice work with these super wall breaks around the outside. The Queen still got her ability. And Royal Champ coming in to take care of that single Inferno. Free spell going down. She does get the job done. She's on 1 HP. Queen can get in towards the CC in the core. 25 seconds left. There goes the Queen's ability. Trying to speed things up. We've only got storages left. So much on the field here. And this is going to be a triple. From Valerie coming in. Adam with the witches. Nice stuff there. Great stuff with the super wall breaks, guys. That is a boon. If I can find. There we go. Good stuff, Fathom. Taking us to 5-2. 3 stars all the way. Yeah, sorry, Power Mama. I did say the Wolfie. I probably wouldn't get in if I could. But yeah, I just watched the end of the last war, switched accounts, and this one had started. There we go. Valerie then with the early triple. Taking the lead in this one, but we are still Penta, still to come in for their second attack. And that was 3 stars from Valerie. Oh, I think 30 minutes left, we caught up. We've got now Ginger George over on YouTube. OP name coming in there, Ginger George, welcome in. How's it going? Are we just wandering by, or are we supporting anyone in particular? We didn't even do prediction, guys. We didn't get a chance to do anything. We just came in. Let's catch up with that. Beat that other prediction. That one's finished. We've got a live coming in again. GK Tim, I am so behind. Wow. Anyway, Ginger George, how's it going? How's your day going over there? We've got dragons coming in. We've got 4 invisibility spells. GK Tim for Penta coming in. Okay, George, thank you for that. Appreciate it, buddy. In comes the blimp bomb then towards the town hall. Looking for that rage spell first, the invisibility spell, out come the super weeds then. Going to work, the tornado trap sprung straight away there, pulling those super weeds away from that town hall. Nice work on those invisibility spells though, perfect timing. And the town hall about to fall here, and we get the enemy king as well. Not quite, we do pull the CC. Enemy king survives that attack, but we do get the town hall down. I'm really good, thank you for asking. Headhunters tackling the baby drag. Baby drag is going to lose that battle. He does get through one of them though. Single archer looking to tackle the lava hound down at 6 o'clock. Nothing else in on the field at the moment. Baby drag steps in again. Does finish off that second headhunter. And the queen can come in for that lava hound. Pops the lava hound. Minions help clear the pups and these dragons. And start in a path straight up from 6 o'clock. Pushing into that sweeper. We've got the enemy king in there. We've got the enemy queen in there. The scatter shot. There's the early warden tone. The rage spell now can take everything into that queen compartment with the scatter shot. Need to get to that sweeper as well and progress further forward here. Pushing up the outside of this base. Enemy king is about to fall as well. King's ability fired up around that single inferno. The royal champ steps in at 3 o'clock. Dragon split in the middle there. Trying to chase this royal champ down there. Locked onto the royal champ. The royal champ falls in the core. Single inferno has gone down by the attacking royal champ. Pushing up towards the scattershot next in this top compartment. We've got the single inferno in there as well. A lot of work to do for these 4 dragons that are left. And the warden has gone down. Royal Champ's ability does go off. He's tackled by that scattershot now. Loon over the top of the scattershot. Can we get it down? One more shot. It goes. And the Royal Champ falls to the defending warden. Queen is pretty low on health. We've got the defending warden. Has got that ability still. And that ability is fired. Can the dragon get the warden down? He can. Queen will get the Tesla. Can she get to that Wiz Tower? Does the Wiz Tower, the mortar goes down. The dragon is tanking that archer tower. The queen can get the archer tower done. Is it going to be? Have we got enough time? 15 seconds left. Is it going to be 80%? No, 86 we're going for. We're all wrong on the guesses at the moment. We get the archer tower down. We've got 5 seconds. It's almost a triple. We're trying hard. We get it. Oh my days. Well done, GK Tim, coming in with that triple. Everyone thought it was going to be a fail. And it gets through. Nice stuff. 3 stars. The Quattro likes that one. 3 stars with the dragons. Good stuff. Right, I was trying to get a prediction done, guys. And Penta keeping level with that one. 3 star of clutch. Exactly, Ginger George. Spot on. That was the clutch out of the death of hell, that one. That was the last breath of that dragon, the last second of the attack. Getting the 3 stars in. Look, guys, I've only found these. I'm going to do a prediction. Let's start one. Who's going to take it? Will it be Penta? Or will it be Mallory we'll put in there? Perfect timing with that last freeze. It was OP stuff. I really just did it. I thought it was going to be not time. It would have been time felt. There you go. The predictions in chat, guys. Spend those channel points. See who you think is going to win this one. And I've only just found out I can't bet on it myself. That's bad. Fair enough. Fair enough. Five apiece, guys. Enter just behind on that destruction. Let 37 to them. 39.2 to Valerie. And they're in again. Attack number three coming in. I'm in on Penta size, says McQuattro. Spending those channel points wisely, we think, or not. We don't know. We are behind at the moment. So we've got four Pekkas in this one. No bat spells. The Pekka smash. The bowler. Hope you guys win. I'm just here streaming at Ginger Jord. I wish I was in one of these clans, but alas, I'm not. I'm here streaming for the Global Clash Cup. It's quarterfinals. Looking to see who can make it through into the semi-finals here. Warden stepping in under that rage spell at 9 o'clock. Stepping in to take care of that expo, that fully maxed expo. What else we got here? We got the fully maxed. Wolfang hosting the stream and raiding as well. Thank you for the raid and the host, Wolfang. Sorry I couldn't get back to you, buddy, but this war had already started. It seemed to take ages to get through that last war. Yeah. Eggers coming in here then towards the town hall. The super wall break in there. Everything gathering up around the bottom. Wolf is in the house. And Winds of Winter. Sup, buddy? How's it going, Winds of Winter? Welcome in. And thank you for that follow as well. We've got the jump spell. And this raid spell taking everything over that second scatter shot there. Top one still waiting to slow these troops down. Got the lava hound popped in the core. The poison spell goes down. The queen hanging back with the witches. Trying to chase those lava pups down. The royal champ stepping in. 4 o'clock. In towards this single inferno. Got a free spell here. We're not going to use it. I'm just going to force that champ's ability. We take care of the single inferno. And the Pekkas are dying in the core. Royal champ tackling the eagle. Both multis locked onto the queen. Royal champ is about to take care of the scattershot in that 12 o'clock compartment. What have we got left? Got that free spell going down. Ah, we can't quite get it done. The Pekka is about to fall to the multi in the core. We've got a Valk running that storage. Super goblins coming in as well. Wizard on the top. We're going to get to the mid-80s again. It's a nice try from Zeus War. Got to go. Ginger, thanks for stopping by. Ginger George, welcome in. And see you soon, buddy. Here we go. 84%. What else have we got left? We've got two archers left to drop. But where can we drop them? I don't think we can get anything from them. In they come. Oh, nice effort. They nearly got that gold storage down. 84%. It's a good try. Valerie, given a bit of an opening, enter to come in with that ripple. They take the lead midway. There you go, that's where we're at then. Three attacks in from Valerie, 56%. Two attacks from Penta. Been level pegging all the way. Enter to come in next. Right, where do we get to? Wolf. It's okay, I forgot to turn on my voice. Our mama did come in and said, you forgot Wolf. I said, no, I did say to you, I probably wouldn't get back. I saw the score come up. I said, thanks very much, both of you. Switched accounts, got to this one, and it had just started the first attack. As we watch Eve Muffin coming in. With a Lalo from Eve Muffin, we got Zap Lalo coming in. Can we get that Lalo God emote going? I see Zaps coming in around the eagle. Scatter shot goes down as well. Good stuff with the zaps. Sneaky Goblin in at 10 o'clock and on both elixir drills. Popping up those Teslas there at 11 o'clock. Blimp coming straight in towards the town hall then. Also CC's headhunters. Tornado trap there, but the Sneaky Goblin's getting the town hall down and we do spring that tornado trap nice and early. So the Ice Golem the Super Wall Break in at 10 o'clock. King, Queen, and About for Good Measure, all stepping into that compartment. King's Ability Force nice and early. Coming in towards that defending Warden. Queen backing him up all the way. And we get to that single Inferno. No, the King is going to go down. Queens take care of the Expo though. And she will get that sweeper. And the Queen is about to be forced on that ability by that single Inferno, but she's really low on health now. She's going to get the Bomb Tower. Cannot quite get that Tesla. She's about to go down. In comes a Giant with the Royal Champ then at the top into those two Teslas. Wow, look, we've got most of the... We've got this good value from this Sui coming in. The Royal Champ's ability is about to be fired. Remember, the Town Hall's already down. We're into the mid-30s, but a lot of core defence has gone here. We've already lost a Scattershot. We've already lost the Eagle. This Lalo then spread right across the top into an early haste spell. Down towards that first air defence there in that 3 o'clock compartment. Poison spell for the Lava Hound. And the Headhunter's under there. We do progress over that air defence in towards this single Inferno and the Warden Tome going off, protecting those loons from that Scattershot. And three or two of them do wander that way. Three of them wandering that way. Oh, look at all those air mines coming up, trying to stop those loons. We do get over the top. We can't quite get that Scattershot finished in the core. Is that going to be what stops this attack dead in its tracks? It's a really nice try from Eve Muffin. We've still got a big pack of loons left here. We're going in towards that Whiz Tower though, and that Scattershot is... It's being held off by those minions, but now turns round towards these loons, and it is going to finish those loons pretty quickly. And the Warden. 5 seconds left, we're into the high 80s. Nice try, Eve Muffin. Who we got now? We've got Rita over there on YouTube and Great MJ. Hey pal, welcome in guys. Good to see you. How's it going? How's your day going? 7-8. But we're so close again. Mallory still got that lead on that destruction. 56 to 54.6. Average of 93.3 to 91. These guys are giving it everything. That's what we've had. There's the hype from Wolfang J. Bit 90s and high 80s here. Two triples, each one each side. Come on, Penta. Come on, Penta. Juve coming in there with a nice try. Lucky stepped in a little bit late for me. I did get the titles and the logos changed. Did a manic dash over here and the last war overran. But we made it in time. Welcome in, Juve. How's it going? How is your day? Come on, Penta, says McQuattro. Oh, we've got about 2 minutes to wait for the next attack. There will be Valerie in next. It's close, pretty close. Still can go either way. Two attacks left apiece, fighting for the quarterfinals. Is this my clan, Great MJ? Oh God, I wish it was, but no, alas. No, no disrespect to Warmongers, guys. I wish I was sat here. I'm in Penta at the moment. No, it's not my clan. If only, that's all I can say, if only, but no. I'm just in here streaming this Global Clash Cup quarterfinal, sponsored by Creek and Clash and Agam, guys. Who's going to make it through to the last four? One of these two is going through. Pretty inseparable at the moment. Californian? No, actually, Penta, a German. Penta from Germany. And Valerie are from Spain, so it's a German-Spain matchup here. And any second now, you're about to see Valerie coming in. Who have we got left to attack for them? We've got Rogon and Riga Torres still to come in. Penta, we've got EPI and Zakir, and here comes Drogon. That's right, not necessarily to know. Good guess, just he found some miles out. Unlucky, great MJ. There's Zaps coming in around that single inferno at the bottom. World Champ stepping in for that single shot. Limp coming over the top. Inferno Tower goes down. We've got three spells of invisibility in here. We've got dragons. We've got boosted troops. This is a flybrid, guys. Down goes the blimp. Down goes the spells of invisibility. No rage there, though. And we were probably just looking to get the Royal Champ and possibly the CC there. Didn't quite get that way. And the Royal Champ is on 1 HP. And we've still got the two super minions in here. The poison spell going down. The dragons coming in. And the super minion spread right up here to 330. And a push in towards that town hall. Two dragons taking care of the super minions. And they're going to push right down to 6 o'clock to start clearing the trash on the outside as the rest of the flybrid pushing in over the town hall. Look at that Royal Champ on 1 HP and still stopping those dragons. But the Royal Champ does fall. Warden Tome protecting everything through that Gigabomb explosion. And these dragons pushing into this next rage spell with the super minions, trying to get through into this multi inferno in the core. Hell of invisibility used there as well. Should see that multi go down. It does. King's ability was used at the top there. Queen and the Warden, all three royals working around with those super minions at the top. The dragon have gone from the core, just the one on the outside now. Pushing in towards this eagle, we've got the freeze over the air defense and the enemy king. Super minion on his own trying to get the eagle down. Queen's ability forced, air defense down. Eagle is about to fall. Can we do this, guys? Quattro is saying rip. 87%, loads of time left. Super minions are going to fall to that single inferno. Queen's ability was used, and we did use that last free spell. So nothing to protect the queen here. She's about to go down to this single inferno. Just the king and one super minion left. Super minion about to go down as well. It's a really good try, Drogon. But it's not going to be a triple. 97%, two stars. Nice try. What great MJ saying, what are your thoughts on E-Drag Loon strategy? It's often called spam. I'm not very good at it personally. When you see it used really, really well, it's quite impressive to watch. Now, these guys at this level know what they're doing with it. Plus with Quattro in the chat here. He's an air specialist. But for me, I'd rather use Ground or Lalo. I don't get much luck with Dragon. Mine tend to have, unless mine have got sat-nav on them, they don't go the way I want them to. There we go, guys. It's 9-7. 75.4 to Valerie now. 54 from Penta. Penta to come in next. We've got Zakia or EPI coming in for their fourth. No, you're not a pro. Not in your eyes, not yet. Not yet, McQuattro, that's what you got to say, not yet. Next year, 2021, big year. Gotta be better than 2020. Surely it is gonna be better than 2020. So, again, can to take the advantage. Waiting for them to come in for their fourth. A triple will be a good time to take the lead. Oh yeah, no, base next is a triple from a Quattro who's coming saying that he's supporting Penta here, hoping the next one is a triple for them. AMJ saying he's never seen a hybrid fail in any champion. You're talking about the top championships. Most of those guys triple most of the time, but you do see them fail. I think a lot were failing as soon as the update fell. Last update. But they've caught up again now. Hybrid's still pretty strong, definitely. And still used quite a lot. Here we go then. Enter Zakia in. Good luck. We've got 6 zaps, 2 quakes, and dragons again. Dragons seem to be popular tonight. McQuattro, you'll be happy again. In come those zaps. And the quakes around that inferno, and the air defense in that top compartment. One dragon in with a minion, helping clear that top stuff. Two loons, and the stone slammer coming in from 9 o'clock. Different approach here. Dragons again in. Drip feeding these dragons in here. Good stuff, patience. And we've got that funnel created now for the rest of the dragons to go straight in towards this town hall. Stone slammer has popped. And the loons and the dragon are going to take care of the air defense and hopefully get this enemy queen down as well. Oh, just not going to finish that queen off. There's the warden tome. We get the town hall down. The rest of the dragons will finish the queen. And the royal champ comes in. We've got king and queen in at 1 o'clock. The royal champ came in from 8 o'clock. Single inferno falls. Good stuff. We've still got a freeze in the bank here. Rage spell over that eagle in the middle. Dragons taking care of the scatter shot at 3 o'clock. This is already looking good. Already looking good. Great MJ, good to see you, buddy. Take care. Hope to see you again soon. Have a good Christmas, if not. Locked onto this bottom scattershot. And that scattershot falling as well. Royal Champ trying to clear this. We've got one more single inferno to deal with. And we've still got the Queen's ability here as well. Queen coming around the top. This is only going one way, isn't it, with the freeze? Got to, surely. This is going to be an awesome triple coming in with the drags. Closing in on that single inferno. The last thing to fall here with the Queen's ability. Boom. Boom. Thank you for the compliment, great MJ. Wow. There you go. That's how you do it with the drags. Awesome attack, says McQuattro. He did get it right. It was a 3-star. All the way. Let's give him that 3 stars. Good stuff. I need a dragon god now, don't I? I've got a Lalo god. I need a dragon god. I need one for every troop, probably. Look at all that 3-star hype coming in from Wolfang J as well. Good stuff. OP stuff. N9. Wow. What a time to take the lead in a war. One attack left. Was it under 2 minutes? That's a good thing. Did it actually start? Well, let's say. I would say a second under 2 minutes. The clock started at 2:08, but the first zaps didn't come in until 1:59, I don't. But yes, I think it was under 2 minutes. Awesome. We've shown that together we're stronger than ever. But to keep making a difference, we need to look at that afterwards again. If you're a man and you've had corona. Okay, guys. Who are we going to watch? You might just have the antibodies. Who are we going to watch? I did do a prediction. I think it's finished. Wolf. Search Donate Plasma or call 0300-123-2323 today. I think it finished. No one wanted to spend their channel points. Oh, look, we got up to 493 followers, but not quite at 500. Don't forget to check out Twitter, guys. I've got a giveaway going on Twitter. The usual. Brazil coming in, ban 444. Oh, if only you were in the right country, ban. This is Germany, Spain. Enter Valerie. Global Clash Cup quarter final about to be decided. Both teams coming in on 5 minutes. Who's going to win? Enter, take the lead in the penultimate attack. Wolf Fang J coming in with those bitties as well. Thank you, Wolf. Appreciate it, buddy. Well, we're in. Let's go and watch this one then. It's in first. I think we know with the strength of Penta that Riga Torres has to triple, really. And we've got E-Drags. Air is winning this one tonight. Can we get the triple here? We haven't come in from Penta yet. We're not quite in on that side. In come all the E-Drags then, straight across the top. Warden Tome straight away, as you would expect with the E-Drags. The Stone Slammer in towards that 3 o'clock channel. The Queen is in at 11. Baby Drag helping clear the outside at 3. Two Rage Spells into the base. King steps in at 10. E-Drags bunched up around the Eagle. We get the Scattershot down at the top. We get the enemy Queen down. Got a freeze over the enemy Queen and that Expo. E-Drags bunching together. We got Super Minions coming out of the CC. The Poison is down. Freeze over the Town Hall. The Queen locked on as well. Town Hall goes down. Oh, those E-Drags getting a lot of pressure from this multi in the court and we can't quite get it done. I don't think they locked onto the enemy King. And that multi is still stood up here. The rage for the world champ. Gonna get the multi down. He's gonna get the scatter down. But she's not gonna finish off that super minion. Oh, she does. Look at that. She proved me wrong. OP stuff from the Royal Champ. Can they do it? Everyone's saying fail. Everyone's saying rip. Come on, Royal Champ. It is too much for her. That top Tesla farm up there. One E-Drag left then. 85%. Two star. We know that's a two star. Let's see what is going to be happening on the other side. EPI coming in. Again, we've got Dragon's McQuattro. There goes that Warden Tome. The Town Hall has already fallen here. The Queen's still got her ability. We've got one more Rage Spell in the bank as well. King's ability forced on the outside. The Queen, she's going to step outside here. We get the enemy Queen down as we push in towards that multi in the middle. Rage Spell for those remaining Dragons trying to push in towards the Expo. Still a lot to take care of here in that 9 o'clock compartment. We've got the two Wiz Towers. We've got the Tesla Farm around the Eagle. Dragons are all low health there. But they are pushing in. Queen's still got her ability. But nothing. Oh, there's an opening at the top. The Queen can walk round. We get the Teslas down. We're moving in towards the Eagle. Defending Warden down. That's a triple. That is a triple all the way. It has to be. OP stuff from Penta and EPI and two triples. Stealing this one at the end. And Penta go through into the quarterfinals of the Global Clash Cup. Can't find the sounds quick enough. That's a boom. Why don't they rock for me? They rock for you, McQuattro. You need to show me how to do some attacks. That's three stars. Would have been. It's three stars this time. There we go. Three stars. And there's confirmation then. Still 2 minutes left of battle day, but five attacks apiece. Enter 13. Valerie, unlucky GG's 11. And this is what we had, guys. Enter coming in with those two strong triples right at the end. Nothing's below, much below 90 most of the way through. OP stuff from both guys. Look at the average destruction. There you go. Average destruction 93.4 to 94.6. Absolutely. No one watching over on YouTube. Yeah, my YouTube channel is a little bit low. I don't really use YouTube much. I only sort of stream to it just to keep it ticking over, really. GG's and a great war. OP stuff. If you think that's low, you should see Trovo. That is even low. Right, let's have a look at a couple of these triples back, guys. The opening one coming in from Fathom. This is nice. Look, he's got four super wall breaks in here. And he saves them. He doesn't use them all, and he saves them for when the witches start going around the outside. Beautiful stuff. This was the opening triple. Yeah, there's lots of different. There's about four or five people streaming this one, possibly. Over on Twitch. I think when you compare YouTube to Twitch, so McQuattro, massive. Twitch is tiny compared to you. Twitch is more favoured for the smaller streamers because you get the rewards earlier. In come these witches to the top. Pushing in towards that single inferno, the king in. The siege barracks dropped at 6 o'clock. There goes the first super ball break. Not getting much value from that one. Does open up that channel though nicely. Didn't quite get into that second level wall. That sea of skellies pushing in towards the town hall. They will get the town hall down and they will be destroyed by that gigabomb. Look at all those skellies pushing in there. Absolutely flooding that compartment, taking the enemy king down as well. Swarm city, but there's that gigabomb and that's the end of those skellies. And we're waiting for those to respawn as we see Valks coming out of the siege barracks. Another super wall break opening up that top compartment. Good stuff. And yet another one coming in here. Breaking through into that next compartment behind that scatter shot. Good stuff. And one more super wall break still in the bank. Coming in from the top, I believe. My memory serves me well. And in it comes. Opening up that top compartment beautifully and letting the queen get out there and access to that single inferno, more importantly. Brawl champ coming in to snipe it from the back. Free spell used, she does get it down. She's on 1 HP. Beautiful stuff with those wall breaks at the back end of this base with the witches overpowering it. There you go, we're on clean up. That was the opening triple from Valerie. Alas, was there only one, unfortunately. The rest of their two stars were high 80 90s. There's confirmation, guys. Enter into the quarterfinals of the Gothic division. That's the wrong button again. Then we stepped into Fathen actually tripled there, and then his base got tripled by GK Tim. Enter. Take care. Quattro, thanks for popping in. See you soon, buddy. Enjoy that Christmas liquor if I don't catch up with you before. So again, this was dragons coming in on the first one. We got four spells of invisibility. Looking to get that town hall down here. We did find the tornado trap here. Unfortunately, that tornado trap does wreck those super whiz a bit. It does get the town hall down though. Pulls them away. Job done. Baby drag killing the headhunter. Queen can get to work on that lava hound and the drag starts straight in here. Nice L-shaped path for them to work up to that eagle. Early warden tome. And the king does pull a few of those drags into the middle. The rest push up towards the eagle. And then they turn that corner to walk up to that top scatter shot. Does start hurting a few of these dragons. Luckily those loons are tanking for it. The royal champ can sneak in underneath, gets the scatter shot down. This is the one where you think it's just about not going to do anything. We're just about run out of steam, but no. We get through, the queen hangs on with this dragon here and it scrapes through on the last breath. This is a clutch triple and a half from GK Tim. Freezer three, whatever it is, just getting it done there with those three troops left. Beautiful stuff. That was their first triple of three. And then they saved their last two triples to the end, Matt. And Zakir coming in with the penultimate one. This gave them the lead in the fourth match. Six zaps, two quakes, again, Dragons. Dragons proving really popular. You get the air defense and the single, the Inferno Tower down there at 12. And look, he drip feeds the Dragons in here to create a lovely funnel with the Stone Slammer. Rest of the Drags push in towards the Town Hall. All bunched together, Warden Tome, Town Hall down, job done there. Cruel Champ comes in at 8 o'clock, King and Queen in at 2. Tesla Farm pops up there in that 3 o'clock corner. There's too much left here. Scattershot down at 6, and the Dragons with the Queen and the King ripping through that Tesla Farm on the outside. Only the single Fernal left to try and stop this attack with that free spell. Down it goes. Last of all, beautiful stuff from Zakir. Another 3-star from them. And their final one, finishing this war off, the Eye. Again, look, Dragon. How Dragons have proved popular in this war. Flint Bomb, Spell of Invisibility in there. Taking care of the Royal Champ, we take care of the Inferno Tower, nearly getting the King down there as well. Royal Champ steps in. Again, that Spell of Invisibility used there, and can take that Scattershot down. Good stuff. And then the Dragons in, with that L-shaped path created beautifully for them. Right in towards the Town Hall. Warden, I missed that in the first one, but we see the Tornado Trap going off in front of the Town Hall. But the Warden Tome protecting everything through that, and the Heal spell in the middle there as well, giving those Dragons that extra bit of life to tackle this multi in the core. And this was a well-worked triple. A lot of stuff left around that Eagle, but too much coming in to that top compartment with those Dragons. Rushing that one at the top and finishing this one off for Penta. Beautiful stuff. Penta going through into the quarterfinals of the Gothic Division. Well done. Well done. That's it. I'm done. We had the predictions. We had two wars. It was a bit of a quick rush and a dash to this one, but we got there. We did see all the attacks, so thank you, Penta, for that one. Thank you, Valerie. Unlucky. Nice try. GGs both, and congratulations. Go through in for fun. I'm done, guys. I'm just going to call it quits there. Thanks for watching. Thanks for the follows. Thanks for the bits. Thanks for the subscriptions. Thanks for everything. Take care. Stay safe. And I will see you on the next one. But for now, I'm bugging out, guys. Stay safe.